Hi everyone, I'm Grahtles, and welcome to another Best Start episode in Satisfactory. So this is episode 16, and I know I gave you a little false start with those turbo motors. Nope, we're not doing turbo motors. That's just another factory I don't want to bore you with, but I did show you exactly where I put it and what it looked like. Today we are doing uranium. Yes, I'm getting radioactive here, and I have my hazmat suit, so we're good. I also have my iodized whatever mask going on here. What is this? Iodine infused filters. Make sure you have a lot of those before you start your uranium nuclear power plant. But anyway, that's where we're headed today, and it's in kind of a two-part thing. We have a first part and a second part. So yeah, I hope you hold on. I have a lot of trains to show you because we are pulling in a lot of stuff, and we had to get really high to get to this. So yeah, we're all the way up here. It was a hike, and there's one of our trains. And I don't know why I didn't delete this. Let's delete that. Oh, I can pick up these. Not that I need them. But anyway. Oh, more stuff. I'm a hoarder. Anyway, I'm gonna fall down into here until we hit the electric. Hopefully we hit it. There we go. Got a little nervous there for a second. But anyway, nuclear is the most complicated things you'll do in this game. It's got a lot of moving parts. A lot of people, when I've watched the videos, literally make everything on site. I have plenty of stuff coming into our factories that I decided to pull everything I could in because it just made sense to me. I'm making it. I had back logs of it. I might as well use it and make it a little less complicated to explain to you how to do it. So this first train station, we have encased beams. We have concrete. We have another concrete because one is for part one, one is for part two. I wanted to make sure we had plenty. Silica, that's part two. AI limiters, that's for part one and two, and stators for part one and two. We also have another train. Here's this one. It's looking beautiful. I love trains. But anyway, down where our sulfuric, oh my god. Down where our sulfur is and our nitrogen gas, I am no longer pulling sulfur for our black powder. We are pulling it for our nuclear power plant. And I'm also picking up the gas from there. The gas is still going to advanced aluminum, but it's also now coming to us over here because we have plenty. So anyway, let's go ahead and get down to where the nuclear is being, well, was built. You might see that beautiful circular building up ahead. That was made by Jemzin. He's a good friend of mine. We share our Discord together. In our cyberpunk world, we made a cyberpunk world. One day I'll bring that up on. I'm getting hit by a train. I might as well take it. We made this in our, well, he made this in our cyberpunk world, and it was for storage, and it was awesome. And I wanted it in my world, so I kind of imported it in. So anyway, here we are, and this is our nuclear power plant. Now, I know you've probably seen many videos where this is just complete chaos because they were making stators on site, AI limiters on site, silica on site, concrete, and encased beams all on site. I didn't want to do that. So here's our one train. And like I said, some of this is for part one, some is for part two. And then over on the other side, we have another train coming in. That all is for... Well, the gas is for part two, and the sulfur is going to be split for part one and two. And yeah, let's go ahead and show you part one. So I do have photos for everything I'm doing, and I will post them after each one. So here we are making electromagnetic control rods. So over in here, we have four making electromagnetic control rods. Three of them is for part one. The fourth one is for part two. So now I have this big storage area. It's pretty funny. I have these geothermals too, because they're just cool looking. So, but anyway, yeah, three of these are going to be for our uranium nuclear power plant. And then we're going to have a plutonium one, and that's going to be part two. So here is our big old sign that says part one uranium. And we won't use those electromagnetic rods for a little bit. So yeah, let's go ahead on to step two. So step two is this. This is four refineries making sulfuric acid. So we have water coming in, one pump, and one water extractor, and we have it turned down to 30 per minute because our next step is actually putting out a waste product of water, which we are pulling back underneath. As you can see down here, we have, I can open up this ugly bottom here. Right here, it's pulling from this machine and bringing it back to our water here to be recycled. And I am being DM'd by fucking Jemzin right in the middle of this. I'll be right back. Alright, back to the video. Encased uranium cells. In this step, you have four blenders. And then when we look inside of them, this is where uranium's gonna go. Your concrete, remember we brought in two, one of them is for here. And that sulfuric acid, which is giving us an output of sulfuric acid. And that is why these are underclocked to 30, because we are receiving 10 from here and this needs 40. So I'm gonna put up the pictures now. Uranium fuel rods. All right, so in this one, we are getting those encased uranium cells from our blenders. We are bringing in those encased beams that we imported with our trains. And here's where those three assemblers from over there are coming into play, and we're putting them into here. So we're splitting them up evenly right into the five manufacturers. And that's going to make us uranium rods. So I'll put up the pictures right now. So the fifth step, we have nuclear power plant and it's uranium rods. So let's go ahead and look in. We have 10 of these nuclear power plants. So out of the five manufacturers making the fuel rods, they're getting split up by manifold. You can split them up either way, but I would let them fill up with the rods before you actually start them. So each one is at full at 50. We also have water coming in. So down below, I have 15 water extractors overclocked to 240. Part of that's going to be for part one, and part of that is going to be for part two. So we have 10 nuclear power plants. 10 of those water extractors that are overclocked by two, pushing out 240, because each of these take 240, are coming up here. The other five will be for the plutonium later on. I will show you the water extractors in a moment, but this outputs waste. So I'm going to put the photos up right now. Alright, so all 10 of our nuclear power plants are putting out uranium waste. And I set up four containers to hold this while I made the plutonium. So along this line, we actually are pulling in from five of these, and then we took the other five and split them. That is because in part two, we're going to need 75% of the uranium waste for one part and 25% of the waste for another part in the plutonium. So we don't have to worry about that yet. We're not up to part two yet, but that's how we're going to split up our waste eventually. If you don't want to do it right now, you don't have to. You can wait until you get to part two. But anyway, all of it is being stored, and the 25% is being stored down here. And here's a photo of that. All right, we're now up to part two plutonium. So, remember that waste we were putting 75% out to? Well, that's going to come down this line, but we're not up to that just yet. First, we have to make a refinery right here that has the sulfur and the water in it. Remember I set up two extra water extractors. One was going to the sulfuric acid up there. The other is coming to this refinery and this blender. So this one is making nitric acid, and we are using the nitrogen gas we were pulling in, and we're using half the water from the water extractor that we're using for this for in here. This is also grabbing some iron plates from our train station back over in there, which is bringing in beams, iron plates, and heat sinks. These two, the output of the nitric acid and the sulfuric acid, are going and getting split into these two blenders. These two blenders are making non-fissile uranium. So let's open them up. So we have that uranium waste. We're bringing in that silica we were bringing in from the other train station. And then here's our nitric acid and sulfuric acid. That is going to two of these. So here we merged our uranium fissile. That is going out to this particle accelerator, which is making plutonium pellets. Here is where we're getting that 25% waste coming in. So 75 waste going into these blenders, 25% of the waste is coming into this one particle accelerator. So now we have these plutonium pellets. They are being output to three assemblers, and they're getting mixed with concrete. So we got one, two, and three. Remember, I had two concrete coming in from the train station. One of those concrete is now coming to part two, which is making encased plutonium cells with the plutonium pellets and the concrete. So that is coming in here. As you can see, there's our concrete, and there is our pellets. So now we're making the encased plutonium cells. That is coming out to two manufacturers. So now in this one, we're getting the plutonium cells, the steel beams, and remember that one electromagnetic control rods that we didn't use at the beginning? That's coming in and getting split up into these two, and then we're bringing in our heat sinks. That is making our plutonium fuel rods. So here you got the heat sinks. There's our steel beams, our electromagnetic rods, and then the plutonium pellets. These two now come out and go into five more power plants. So these five power plants are taking that five water that I still have from our 15 that's overclocked to 240 and our plutonium fuel rods, and they're going to make power. But I have not filled them up yet. So this one is full, and we still have to fill up the rest down the line before I turn them on. I do that so this way everybody is kind of starting off even. So once these fill up, we'll power it up and we'll have 5 more nuclear power plants. So now with just 10 power plants running, let's take a look at what we have. So I have 51,000 watts. I think we started out at 26, so we basically doubled our power. But anyway, this is going to put out some plutonium waste. It's not too much. We don't have it running yet, but we can't do anything with this plutonium waste until tier 9, which is fine because they come out very slowly and we're just gonna have to wait for that to happen. All right, so the last look we're gonna take is our water. So in the middle here, I have the 15 water extractors. 10 are for the nuclear part 1, and that's the uranium, and then 5 of them go to the plutonium part 2. So on this side, I have our water extractor for our sulfuric acid and our whatever nitric acid up there. And then this one is going to the sulfuric acid for part 1. So part 2, part 1. And everything in the middle is just overclocked to 240. And like I said, 10 to part 1, 5 to part 2. So as you can see, we are running out of gas masks really quickly because it's very radioactive over here. So you do want to build your power plants not close to any of your factories or you will get radioactive. And that's not a good thing. You need plenty of masks. I probably had gone through a little less than 100 maybe. And yeah. So you will need your hazmat suit and that too. All right, so that's gonna conclude today's episode on nuclear power. I really do hope I broke it down into easy steps for you guys to follow. As I said before, you don't have to have nuclear power. If you don't wanna do this step, don't do it. Just really, you're gonna need a lot of power though for phase 4. We're gonna do that next episode, but you could always pull from some more oil or anything else like that and build up your power that way. But if you've never done it before, I've never done it before. This is the first time I've done it, and it's interesting to do. I enjoyed doing it. It took me a long time to do, but yeah, I got it done. And if you do it in the parts and break it down simple, I think you should be fine. So if you enjoyed this episode and it was helpful, please like, subscribe, comment, share. And thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.